All right, so this experience has probably been insane for you. Tell me what was your like aha moment that made you feel like, okay, I'm here on American Idol. Oh my God, this is real.
You know, when I was sitting on the stool for the first time, just earlier today, actually, I felt like I looked at my wife up in the stands and I was like, my life's about to change.
Yeah.
And that was kind of it for me.
So. What can the viewers expect from you music-wise? What kind of artist are you? And even if they make you kind of change up genres, what are you going to stay true to?
I'm really going to stay true to who I am, you know, and that's a very generic answer, but, you know, I have all kinds of genres that I like to pull from, and, you know, people might say I'm country by the way I talk or by the way I dress or act or something, and that's fine. I'm totally cool with that, but I don't want people to think I'm just country. I want them to think that, oh, he's got all of these things, because I have so many different influences, and I grew up with all kinds of different music, from Ann Murray to B.J. Thomas to Fleetwood Mac to Steppenwolf to, you know, Three Dog Night to... you know, the Gaithers to all these people. And I have all of those influences that I want to incorporate every week.
Do you think that's going to help you stand out? Because there are a couple country singers still left on the male side. And, you know, you can have more than one, obviously, but sometimes you guys split the vote. So do you think that will kind of help you stand apart?
You know, that is kind of an issue that we talked about earlier when we got in, you know, when we got done with the show, was that are we going to cancel each other out votes-wise? And honestly, I don't really think we are, because even though we are kind of country, we're still all really different. Just the three of us, so I'm not really worried about that, because there some people are going to love CJ, some are going to love Dexter, some are going to love me. I hope they love me, but you know they're all great musicians, and you know I don't think we'll cancel each other out, because we're just very different people.
What's the first song you ever learned how to sing or play or perform?
Oh man, that's it's too late to think. I think if I had to pick one, it's either Unchained Melody. Other than a gospel song, or maybe Heirloom by Amy Grant, I think was the first song I did in person. I'm not 100%, but that was a long time ago. But
what's the one album you brought with you that you're going to listen to on off days, like when you don't have to learn a song?
My favorite album is Legacy of Cash. It's one of Johnny Cash's album when he was with Trent Reznor for the American Music, and that is my favorite album of all time. Also, Keith Whitley and Willie Nelson, I have them with me. Right before I got married, the morning of my wedding, I put in a Keith Whitley record and just relaxed and got ready. So it's really good, because I'm a sucker for lyrics, and those guys know how to write a good song. So
absolutely. Well, you're going to go inside, you're going to enjoy this night, and hopefully we'll see you top 10 Idol Tour.
Hopefully they'll have some food in there, because
yes,
I'm
there's food.
Good.